I was just baking cookies with my 7-year-old son. We're making shortbread cookies, gingerbread cookies, and peanut butter cookies. And I mentioned something to him that I heard about last month, about someone who posted on social media about how they were making these cookies, paw print cookies, by pressing their dog's paws into the cookie dough. My son was in a state of shock and disbelief when I told him this. He could not believe it was true. And he said, "What is wrong with people? Don't they realize these dogs walk outside on the dirty ground?" And I said, "Yep." And I've been thinking about this. Even though the person who posted this picture wrote that they washed their dog's paw before they did this, I'm thinking you cannot wash a dog's paw enough to make this acceptable. I don't care how many times you wash your dog's paw, I would never eat this cookie. I think it is beyond disgusting. I think the people who do this kind of thing are filth. And I'm sure they see nothing wrong with it. And they will compare the bottom of their dog's paw to our hands. And they'll say, well, human hands are disgusting because we handle money and we handle all this disgusting stuff that's full of germs. I don't care. Think about this kind of stuff that dogs walk in all day, the ground that people spit loogies on, they blow their nose out onto the ground, there's shit and piss, dogs are always walking around where other dogs are urinating and defecating. To me, this is exactly the same as taking cookie dough and shoving it up your ass, flattening it between your ass cheeks, and saying it's fine because you just washed your anus beforehand. I don't care how many times you washed your anus, I'm not going to eat your ass cheek cookies. And putting it under your armpits, even after you washed your armpits, and flattening the dough in your armpits, same thing. I'm not going to eat those cookies. That's disgusting. I really think that dog worshippers have this, like, I don't know. It seems like the more dirty and disgusting something is, the more cute and endearing and funny it is. You can see this in just their choice of preferred dogs. It's like the uglier the dog and the more hideous it appears and the more it slobbers and the more shark-like its fleshy mouth is, the cuter they think it is. It's beyond disgusting. I can only think about my sister that I don't talk to anymore. I remember this one incident that shocked me to my core. She and I were visiting my mother's house and she had washed her genitals with a face cloth, or washcloth, I should say. And she had then wiped down the splashes around the sink with the same cloth, leaving the scent of her filthy genitals around the sink. She came up to me. I didn't know she had done this. She came up to me and she was giggling and she said, "Hey, come over here, smell the sink." And I was like, "Why?" And she said, "Just smell it, just smell it." And she was laughing and I'm like, "Why?" And she pressured me to finally do it. And when I did it, I got the smell of these, you know, of stinky genitals. And I recoiled in horror while she laughed her head off. And I thought, there is something seriously wrong with you. But she didn't see it. She thought this was funny. And I'm like, "You're crazy. I don't know what sort of mental illness you have, but you have a mental illness to think that this is funny in any way, shape, or form. It isn't funny at all. It is extremely disturbing." And she would say that my mother was a germaphobe and would laugh at my mother when my mother would complain about dander and hairs in the home and stuff, and say my mom had a problem. My mom was the one who was mentally sick because she was anal and, you know, a neat freak and whatever. No, it's the other way around. These people, and my sister, by the way, is a dog worshiper. At least she was back when I last spoke to her, which is years ago. And the last time I saw her was, holy shit, like more than 20 years ago. And I want nothing to do with her because she's crazy. But a lot of dog worshipers are similarly disturbed mentally. Things that to them are normal or funny or cute in some way are to the rest of us completely shocking and disgusting. And I mean, these people are filth. And they are definitely part of a cult because, you know, I've talked about cults. the dog cult in previous videos, and so has I Hate Dogs, and you should watch those videos if you haven't already. But behaviors and beliefs that are completely normal and acceptable to members of the cult are seen by other people who are not in the cult as extremely disturbing and crazy. And the fact that my seven-year-old could see how nuts you have to be to press your dog's disgusting paw into cookie dough proves that these people are in a cult and they are beyond brainwashed. They worship these shit eaters. They literally worship them. A friend of mine shared this post that she found somewhere, this article, where a person described their dog as God in dog form. Can you believe that? I can believe it because I know, and I've been saying for a long time, they worship, literally worship these vomit slurpers, these leg humping shit machines. They glorify them and worship them as though they are gods. It's insane. And these people don't realize it. And they will argue with us and come from a place of complete, I mean, they're not rational. Anyway, I just wanted to make this video about these cookies in case you haven't heard about it. And another thing, I saw this, a friend posted it, and she was like, "Don't you hate the look on this asshole's face?" And I'm like, yes, it's the kind of look that says, "Come 1 centimeter too close to me and I will tear your flesh, even though you are a family member, you know, fuck you, freeloader," you know. And what are they trying to say with this message? They're telling us that the Grinch was a dog lover and he was evil. So that makes us what? Worse than the Grinch because we hate dogs? Maybe it's the other way around. I mean, look at all the evil people who loved dogs. Hitler, Stalin, Jeffrey Dahmer, a whole bunch of other psychos. I made a video about this. They loved dogs and their dogs loved them. So what does that say? Well, to me, it says what I Hate Dogs said in his videos. It is righteous to hate dogs. It is a mark of a conscious, empathic, compassionate person with fucking awareness who cares about people, humanity, and the environment. It is righteous to hate dogs. So take that and shove that up your ass, dog lovers. You have no logic whatsoever. I just called you dog lovers. You are not dog lovers. You're dog worshippers. There's a difference. You actually don't even care about your dogs. You think you do, but you don't. Anyway, I'm repeating myself. I hope you guys have a great holiday, a great time celebrating the winter solstice in whichever way you choose to celebrate. Even if you don't celebrate, have a great time. I'm going to be feasting and having fun with my family. My older kids who are out of school for a couple of weeks, I'm so happy to have them home. Unlike the parents who celebrate when it's time for their kids to go back to school, I celebrate when it's time for them to be at home with me because I like being with my kids and they know that. They know that I make them my priority and we actually enjoy spending time together. One last thing, I've noticed that in my last video that I uploaded, comments are mysteriously vanishing. I don't know what's going on. There's something really strange happening because I'm being notified by email that people are commenting and I can read the comments in my email, but then when I go to my channel, the comments are gone. They're not there. I don't know where they went. Sometimes YouTube withholds a comment if they think it can be potentially... if they think it is potentially inappropriate, but I've checked that tab and there's nothing in there, so I don't know where your comments are going. I just thought I would let you know that. I pinned a comment under the video explaining that. But another thing too, I woke up this morning and I saw that that video had 11 dislikes and now it has 5 dislikes. So there's something really strange going on with my channel. My kids are joking and saying that I've been hacked. I don't know. But anyway, just thought I'd let you know that. So have a great holiday, guys, and I'll see you probably in the new year. The future is dog-free.